हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज अवर लेक्चर नंबर 5 एंड दिस इज द पार्ट 2 ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल विच वी स्टडी इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर. इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी सॉल्व दिस न्यूमेरिकल एंड वी फाइंड द सीजनिक वेट ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस गिवन डायमेंशंस. सो this is our plan and this is our elevation. So with the help of given dimension we find the dead load and live load for different structural elements of building. Now we have to solve for base shear and we have a formula for that, that is VB is equal to AH into W. So in our previous lecture we already defined total seismic weight is 51,348.766 kilonewton. Now we have to find AH value. So for that we have one formula. AH is equal to Z by 2 into I by R into SA over Z. And this formula is given in 1893 part 1 2002 at page number 14. So with the help of this formula we have to find AH value. So here Z is equal to zone factor, and in our question it is already mentioned that this building is situated in Ahmedabad. So for Ahmedabad, you see that for Ahmedabad zone factor value is 0.16. That's why here we take Z is equal to 0.16. Now we have to find I. I is the important factor. It is clearly mentioned in our question that this building is the institute building. So for institute building, here we have given clause for institute building or important service or community building, we have to take I is equal to 1.5. That's why here we take I is equal to 1.5. Now we have to find response reduction factor, means R. So for response reduction factor, in our question that is not mentioned any reduction factor value. So we have to assume reduction factor is a special RC moment resisting frame. So for that reduction factor is 5 and here R is equal to 5. If anything is not mentioned in your question, then you have to assume this value. Now we have to find SA over G. For finding SA over G, first we have to find the TA value. TA is the fundamental natural frequency or period. So we have to find fundamental natural period with the help of this formula 0.09 H upon root D. It is the formula which we used for infill wall. Because in our question there is an wall is given. That's why here we take this formula. Otherwise if wall is not present, we have to take formula 0.075 H e power 0.75. Okay. So here we use this formula and here we have to find H and D first. So H is our building is 6 story building and height of the east floor is 3 meter. So our total height of building is 6 into 3 is 18 meter. And our in x direction we have 7 bay and each bay of 5 meter. That's why our base dimension is 35 meter. So here we get H and B D value and we put this value in our formula and we get 0.274 as a answer. Now with the help of IS 1893 2002 part 1, we have to find value for SA over G with the help of this equation or this figure. It is clearly mentioned in code this equations and figure is for 5% damping. If you have given different damping percentage, then you have to follow different factor for that and you have to take this value from the IS code 1893. If you have given, for example, 3% damping, then for 3% damping there is a value given in IS code. You have to take that factor and multiply with SA over G. But here we considered as a 5% damping. That's why here we use this equation or this figure is for finding the SA over G value. So here we have find TA is equal to 0.274 and our soil is, here we assume hard soil. So for TA is equal to 0.274 And for hard soil, this value is lies between this equation. So here we get SA over G value is equal to 2.50. So here we write SA over G value is equal to 2.50. Now we have find all dimensions which we mention in AH formula. After finding that, we put this value in this formula and find the AH value. After finding the AH value, we know that VB is equal to AH into W. So simply we put the equation and put the values of equation and we get 3080.92 kilonewton as a answer. This is our base shear. Now we have to distribute this base shear in our story, each story. So for that we have one formula which is also mentioned in code IS 1893. Q is equal to VB WI HI ka square divided by summation WJ HI ka, sorry, HJ ka square. So for that we have already find VB WI. WI is the weight of each floor. This weight is, we already find this weight for particular floor and roof. So this here we written. This is the height for first floor 3 meter, for second floor from base 6, from base third floor 9, at up to the roof this is 18. So here HI square, that's why here we put it square and we calculate this value, we get this value. Now in our formula we have to find summation W J H J ka square. So we get here summation of this value. So this is the summation and it is equal for all floor. So here we put these all values in our formula. Then formula is Q is equal to VB WI HI ka square divided by WI HI ka square ka summation. So QI we get from this value. Here we seen that in our first floor lateral force is very less, but at roof lateral force is very high. But in case of shear force, this is very. In case of shear force at first floor, shear force is very high because according to IS 1893, shear force is the sum of force above the floor which you have to find the shear force. So if you have to find the shear force at first floor, so you have to sum all lateral force of above the first floor. So we have to find shear force like this. After finding this value, we have to draw a diagram for QI and VI, for lateral force and shear force. So this is the diagram of lateral force and this is the diagram of shear force. So this is the concept how we find the base shear and how we distribute this base shear in different floors when we have not given any direct mass of the building. Thank you.